Good evening. My name is Celeste Reynolds and I teach here at Mashpee High School, and tonight we are experiencing Senior Exhibition Night here at Mashpee High School. This is a wonderful event that we hold in the spring where all the seniors share their senior seminar projects as well as their school to career internships. And tonight, students, as you can see, have a poster board, and that is where they're talking about who they are, what their interests are, and what their project is about, and why they chose their project. They also discover their research, what they learned when they were doing research about their project, and also show evidence. Now, some students haven't finished their project. All projects have to be done by May 1st, so some students are still waiting to get their projects finished, while other students have already finished. But it's a wonderful night for them to share, show all the information that they have learned over the course of the year, and also show the skills and the content, as well as their passions for their project. So I hope sometime you can come and see these wonderful projects. And we're always looking for project evaluators that are coming in May, and we're looking for people to come in for about 2 hours and evaluate students one-on-one while they are presenting their final presentations. But it's a wonderful evening, and you can see year after year the projects keep getting better and our students keep getting stronger, and they are all making a difference in their community. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Tavita Kapp, and my project is focusing on cyanobacteria that's sent to a pond. This was something that I really felt that it really needed to be addressed, and I worked with my mentor, who was Mr. Hobbs, who is the AP Environmental Science teacher here at the Mashpee High School, and I just felt that we both knew that this is something that was important and really needed to be addressed at. So I partnered with Mashpee TV on their videos on talking about San Antonio Pond, about the history, about how climate change affects it, and about how we can do to help improve these ponds. And I'm very thankful for them to help out, and I'm very thankful that I got to be able to help as much as I can.
My name is Hunter Toby. I'm a senior at Mashpee High School, and through my school to career program with Mr. Looney, I was able to secure an internship with the Barnstable County Sheriff's Office, Communications Division and Technical Division, along with working with Joint Base Fire Department. So what I was able to do with the Barnstable County Sheriff's Office is I was in charge of radio programming. So my job would be to program all of the radios for public safety in Barnstable County and all of the public service radios into Plymouth County. So what we were able to do there is working with these types of radios for the state trunking system. And I was also able to work with the sheriff's office to upfit and then de-upfit their police cars when they were sending them to auction or when we were getting in new vehicles for replacements. I was able to really enjoy the internship because it's something different for me. I've grown up in a police car. I know what a police officer does. I wanted to learn something different about law enforcement and public safety. So I was also able to work in the communications center at Joint Base Fire Department, where they have Barnstable County Dispatch Center. So from there, we dispatch all the emergency calls and take 911 calls for Barnstable County. And secondly, I was able to work with Joint Base Fire Chief Emery, to learn the job of a firefighter on Joint Base Cape Cod and further my knowledge into incident command and further into emergency management. I was able to work on the apparatus, learn logistics of my firefighter turnout gear. I was able to respond to emergency calls when they were coming out, and also able to respond to airport rescues using our state-of-the-art crash trucks shown here to respond to emergency calls on the runway. This was a great opportunity. I'm very glad to have it. Thank you very much.
Hi, my name is Jonah Erdman. My senior project was to train 8 students on the operations of our audiovisual equipment here at the high school auditorium. I took 2 full days out of school with the kids to teach them about how to use the different pieces of the lighting equipment, the different pieces of the... Do you want me to restart? I'll restart. Restart the video. Just keep going? Okay. Hello, my name is Jonah Erdman. My senior project was to train 8 students on the operations of our auditorium technical equipment. I spent 2 days out of class teaching them about the lighting and sound, how to operate the different systems we use for different productions we may have. The kids so far have ran the talent show on their own and our recent production of Puffs on their own. And they seem to be really understanding the concepts a lot, better than I actually originally expected them to. I plan on going to college for technical theater and working as a lighting designer or a master electrician on like touring concerts or theater productions in the future.
Hi, my name is Sam Rosam. I'm a senior here at Mashpee High School, and I worked with Mashpee TV for an internship. I worked with Miss Fraser mostly with the Mashpee Minute, and then I also did some of my own solo projects where I'd go and film the sports teams, and I'd make videos for them and take the clips and make videos so they could post it, and so they'd get their fans to come, and so they'd get excited about the games, and so it'd give publicity for the team.
What I really love about it is that this is a class have to attend a monthly math-along, so a minimum of 6 math-alongs throughout the year. They'd have to have a minimum of 40 community service hours, and they would have to participate and give their input and teach others and be mentors to other students in mapping. My research, another thing I found, was about urban areas and how homeless women and homeless men view and take up the space of their areas around them differently. So homeless women usually are more confident in how to map an area. So when they're given a blank piece of paper and they're asked to map a block, they know the direct the
it to you. Most of you guys know me. For those who don't, my name is Sam Kersey, and I'm going to be presenting my Miles for Money fundraiser, which was my senior project. So first, we'll start out with my advisors. So I had two advisors throughout this whole experience. The first one, his name is Lee Doherty, or as I know him as Doc, and he is the founder of a nonprofit organization in Barnstable, Massachusetts, called UKSD, or the United Kids Soccer Development. And he's also been a personal trainer and a longtime mentor of mine. I've grown up going to his events, his UKSD events. He does a lot of beach soccer and a lot of kind of community involvement to kind of bring the community together. And he is who approached me with this project. He asked me, along with three other girls from Massachusetts, to be UKSD representatives for this project. And he is who connected me with the two other organizations that I worked with throughout this project, which was the Coaches Across Continents, which is an organization based out of the United States and the United Kingdom, and the Slum Soccer Foundation, which is based out of Nagpur, India. My second advisor is Mrs. McCush. Most of you probably know her. She is a guidance counselor here at Mashpee. She also has been my varsity soccer coach up until my senior season. She helped me a lot throughout this process. She overlooked a lot of my work, and she also gave me advice to add a civic aspect into this project to give back to my direct community, where later in the year I'm going to be presenting my Miles for Money project to freshmen and junior classes throughout the Mashpee school system to kind of get them in the spirits of community service and giving back. So I, along with Alexa and Jules, had to do a research paper, and I chose to do my research paper on the worldwide water crisis. And there was a lot of interesting things that I learned throughout this whole research paper in the process of researching, but some of the facts that really stood out is that 3.6 billion people in the world have inadequate access to water for at least 1 month out of the year, and it's expected to grow to over 5 billion by 2050. And that is just an outrageous number. That means that about half of the world's population right now don't have good access to clean water for at least 1 month out of the year. Another one that really stands out is that over 1,000 children die every day from preventable diseases caused by poorly sanitated water. And that really just shows that the water crisis isn't always a problem of a lack of water, but it's a lack of the correct practices and filtration systems that it doesn't give communities the clean water that they need. Some other research is that globally, women as collectively spend around 200 million hours a day collecting water. When I began researching this topic, I found that the water crisis is an issue that is directly targeted more towards females, where lots of females, it is their societal role in third world countries to go and fetch water. There's these things called water wives in countries out of India and Pakistan, where these women aren't accepted into society unless they are married. So what they do is they marry someone that they don't really have any sort of relationship with, and they do that so they can get the marital status to be accepted into society, and then the man of the marriage will have someone fetching water for them. So now into my physical project. This began in the fall of 2020. It started where the four UKSD representatives Zoomed with girls from the Slum Soccer Foundation based out of Nagpur, India. And there were four girls from that foundation. And for a few months, we just kind of Zoomed with these girls. We didn't really have any sort of direction on where we were going. We kind of just learned about each other's hobbies, the different holidays that we celebrate, kind of how our everyday lifestyles are different. And as the months went by, we began talking more about harder subjects and deeper subjects. And we kind of started talking about things that we both kind of have to endure as females in our society or just whole community problems as a whole. And we were challenged to build a project around that. And that's when we established the Filter Fresh project in April of 2021. So the picture on the right is just an image of one of the Zooms that we did. Here's just some more images of Zooms that we did. The girl on the top left of the far picture, her name is Nora Dooley. She was the representative of the Coaches Across Continents. She lives in London, and she helped us a lot, and she was kind of a mentor looking over the whole project. And here's just another image of, these are the three other girls that I worked with from Massachusetts. Two of them are from Barnstable, one of them's from Hanson. And then on the left is kind of a digital flyer that we created. It was where we would first started promoting our foundation. On the top right, you guys probably can't read it, but our original goal when starting this project was to raise hopefully up to $2,000 towards this foundation, which we were able to exceed, which is amazing. And then on the right, here's just another image of these Zooms that we partook in. to establish what our project was going to be about. We began to advertise our foundation. We created an Instagram that currently has around 100 followers, and we began posting about the water crisis. We also created a logo for our foundation, and we designed and sold water bottles, which are on the left. We sold those for about $35 a piece, and they came with little wristbands, you can see at the bottom, if you purchased one. And then on the right, this is the logo that we created to represent the Filter Fresh project. We wanted something that incorporated the filters, because that is kind of what our project is based around, and we also wanted to include the two countries that are working together for this project, which is the United States and India. So after we kind of finished that first set of fundraising, we wanted to create an actual fundraising event, and that's when we implemented the Miles for Money fundraiser, which I implemented in the summer of my senior year. And what this fundraiser was is that we had participants find a sponsor to donate a certain amount of money per mile that they completed while exercising, and then they had a week span to complete as many miles as they could exercising, whether it was running, biking, and things like that. We had 32 participants, and we were able to raise $3,225. The image on the right was just a little digital flyer that we created promoting the event. Here's just some more that we created. We did a lot on Canva, and these are what we posted on our Instagrams, trying to market the fundraiser to get people to sign up and participate. So then, this is some pictures of the actual event. Luckily, we coincided it with the fall sports preseason, so I was able to get a majority of the junior varsity and the varsity team of soccer to sign up. I also was able to get some of the golf program to sign up. And two of the girls that I did this project with go to Barnstable, so they were able to get a majority of their program to sign up as well. So our next aspect into this project, which followed into the fall of my senior year, was that we had to get the money over to India. So my next step was to send the funds over to the slum soccer headquarters in Nagpur, and then the water filters were purchased and the distribution plan was executed. So on the right, those are the filters that we purchased. The really cool thing about these filters is that they have a warranty, a lifetime warranty, so whenever they do break to the families that we gave them to, they're able to bring them to the store in Nagpur, India, and they're able to get a brand new one. So it's a lifetime warranty, which is cool. So on December 6th, we were able to distribute to the Bokhar community. So this is kind of just our first of four communities we were able to distribute to. And the girls that distributed them were the girls that I had been Zooming with for the last 7 months, which I think was just such a special thing to this project, where these girls who are from Nagpur were able to directly give back to their own community, which I think is something really special about this project. And then on December 7th, we distributed to the Nanda community, just some more pictures. And then on December 8th, we distributed to the Ambazari community. And then on December 10th, we distributed to the Kanthi community, all within Nagpur, India. So overall, we were able to purchase around 80 filters with our $3,000, and we distributed to four different communities, and this impacted, we think, around 500 people. So the timeline I've basically covered, I'll just focus on a couple of things that I didn't mention. On May 3rd, we sent out a Google form to the followers of our Filter Fresh Instagram, and there we just asked generic questions about the water crisis, kind of what it's about, what parts of the world are mostly impacted by it, and we just wanted to get kind of an insight of what our followers knew about the water crisis, as it is a problem that really isn't talked about a lot. And once we got the data back, we analyzed it, and we began basing our posts on our Instagram around the different topics that were known the best. And then another one that I didn't really talk about is on June 18th, we had a Zoom with the Loena Foundation, which is a foundation that works towards funding other organizations. So what we did is we had to pitch our foundation to them, and they gave us a $500 donation to kickstart our Miles for Money fundraiser. And then overall, I spent around 50 hours doing this project. This is just solely me. This doesn't include the slum soccer girls and their distribution. So throughout this whole process, I learned a lot about myself and a lot about the water crisis. I learned a lot about international relations, which will benefit me a lot next year, as I will be majoring in international business at Fairfield University next year. next year. And I learned a lot about international relations and kind of what it's like to have a career in that field. And it just made my passion for this kind of topic grow even more. I also learned a lot about the importance of learning about other cultures and different lifestyles. As much as I had fun learning about the hard parts of their society, I would say my most favorite thing about this project was just the Zoom meetings when we talked about our different hobbies and the different celebrations and holidays that we do. When we weren't Zooming, we had a WhatsApp that was constantly running. We were constantly sending daily updates of our life, and that was probably my favorite part, was just seeing what they do to a day-to-day life. I also learned a lot about business, which I am going into international business, so that'll help a lot next year. I learned a lot about marketing when I was doing my posts on the Filter Fresh Instagram, and I was trying to get people to participate in the fundraiser and also to purchase the water bottles. And I learned a little bit about what it kind of takes to operate a business, and more specifically a nonprofit business. And obviously I learned about the water crisis, which is a huge, huge global issue that really isn't touched on. So throughout this whole process, I did have a couple problems that I did have to get through. One of them was the language barrier between us, the UKSV girls, and the slum soccer girls of Nagpur, India. They did speak an impressive amount of English, and most of the time we were able to have direct conversations, which was really impressive and really amazing to kind of experience. But obviously it wasn't always perfect, and sometimes they got confused by the things we said, or we got confused by the things they said. And so it kind of just took a lot of patience. We also had a mentor that represented the slum soccer organization who was there through all of the Zoom meetings, so whenever there was any confusion, she was there to kind of clear the air because she was fluent in both languages. And then another problem that we had to go through was that our original plan was to purchase the filters ourselves and then send them over to the slum soccer headquarters. However, there was some international barriers that stopped us from doing that. So instead, we had to transfer the funds over to the slum soccer headquarters, where they were able to purchase the water filters, which was kind of a lengthy process. We started transferring the funds in September. They didn't get them until November, so it was kind of a more lengthy process, but we got it complete. This was such an amazing overall experience that I really wouldn't trade for the world. I learned so much about the different people that I was able to talk to, and these girls that I was able to build relationships with, I will hold these relationships for the remainder of my life. One of the biggest takeaways is that everyone is more similar than we think. The girls that I was talking to, they do have to endure these huge societal problems that we don't always see in the United States, but we were both connected to this project because the slum soccer girls and the UKSD girls all have a passion for the sport of soccer, and that really showed me that no matter kind of what issues you deal with in your society, those people are way more similar to you and I than we think, and that really taught me that. And another thing, which I would say is my biggest takeaway, is that no matter who you are or where you're from, you can make a difference. When I first started this project, being in the small town of Mashpee, if I'm being honest, I thought I was a little in over my head. I was like, this seems like a lot. I don't know if I can do this. And I just found that with passion and with hard work, you can really accomplish anything and you can make a difference in the world. So yeah, thank you.
Thank you.